When I think of archery, I think of three white dudes. Robin Hood, the least useful Avenger Hawkeye, and the elf from The Lord of the Rings. I think it's time we bring some street to the world of bow and arrows.
I can do it on my own time, when I want to do it, where I want to do it. It's just me and my bow and arrows. And that's it.
Juliet, I'm hearing you the GOAT of archery.
GOAT?
Greatest of all time.
Oh, GOAT.
Yeah.
You know, within my realm.
Okay.
Sure.
So you got Juliet and you got LeBron.
Oh, I can't touch LeBron.
Okay.
I've had somebody call me a world-class athlete in archery.
What's the preparation that goes into being a world-class athlete?
A lot of practice.
Man, I was really hoping she was gonna say a wizard or some shit made her good at archery. So walk me through, what's the difference between all these bows?
Archery, you know, dates back to 10,000 BC. They call this a Hungarian horse bow.
Okay. Hungarian horse bow is my stripper name.
And there's a lot more hand making that goes to this. They cut the trees down.
These feathers tied on.
As time progressed, they're a little fancier. They're glued on. You have to heat treat the wood. And as time progressed, this is a longbow. Technology came into play. This is all wood. But you can take it apart. As time progressed, you could add a sight, a plastic rest on here. These are carbon arrows. They fly a lot faster.
Okay.
And then there's the Big Daddy. Okay. This is very similar to what they shoot at the Olympics. And that's it.
Look, guys, I ain't gonna lie. I stopped listening to her a long time ago. I just wanna shoot some arrows. So how much do these things right here cost?
The riser here, that's like $500.
No. You can get a Glock 45 for $500. Two of them, twin Berettas.
The limbs themselves are about another $500.
Wow, I see why Robin Hood was stealing. Ain't that some shit? Steal from the rich and give to the rich bow and arrow dealer. Robin Hood and Lil Jon should've got some twin Berettas and called it a day.
All right, so when you're on these competitions, how many black people do you see in these?
I know of two that I shoot with.
All right, well, you about to have your third black man right now.
Pull back to your,
Shit.
So with an arrow like this, see, I've got one that's a purple and two orange. You'd always want to knock your arrow so that that one odd color, they call it the cock feather.
If you think I'm about to joke about that, y'all, I'm too classy.
In order for the arrow to fly right, you'd want to cock the feather and just look down the shaft of the arrow.
Cock see the that? Feather, looking
see
down the shaft.
Relaxed grip, relax.
All right, relax.
And you draw back to your face, aim at the bottom of that target.
Okay.
Because these arrows will fly a little higher. And I want you to hit the target.
Okay, I want to hit the target. All right.
Bring your fingertip to the corner of your mouth here. Feel
okay.
it. Just slice past it. Nobody hits a target first time ever.
Okay, I just thought I would.
Practice.
Okay.
Point of the arrow. Put your bow arm straight out. It's consistency. You have to draw back and do the same thing every single time. And probably just aim just a little to the left.
Ooh.
Go and collect our arrows real quick, and then we'll do this all over again.
Okay, cool.
You look to make sure the line is clear. You don't want to approach the field while there's people still shooting. You don't want to get shot.
Definitely don't want to get shot.
Okay, good.
Because I'll sue.
You'll sue?
Oh, yeah, in a minute.
Have you recently been the victim of a Robin Hood robbery? Are you an orc that was stuck with an arrow from Legolas? Then call Keraun King Archery Injury Attorney at Law. We'll make sure you're the receiver of slings and arrows of outrageous fortune.
There you go.
Ooh, yeah.
You're on the target.
Okay.
Now, you remember where you aimed?
No.
What? See, that's what you gotta remember those things.
I got ADD, I'm sorry.
Right next to
him. I see now I'm becoming an archery master.
That's right.
You know what? I think I'm ready for the one all the way down there.
You think? All right. We'll give it a shot.
Well, Julie, first shot at 60 yards. You're watching a master at work. Oh, I see it. A little far. Ooh, you just showed out on me, huh? Wow. I feel like this is the worst part. It's the walk of shame, where you gotta walk down 60 yards just to see how much you didn't hit it. So I'm gonna go and take my walk of shame now.
Let's do the walk of shame together.
Yeah, you know, I appreciate you staying here with me through these long 60 yards.
That's what we do. We take care of each other.
I appreciate that. Guys, this time I ain't making this walk no more, so look, let's just edit it like I hit it. I know my editors, they sure wouldn't put this conversation in the show. First shot at 60 yards.
Nicely done.
Oh, I didn't know I was good. Yeah. See, kids, practice and creative editing makes perfect. Sometimes a man can only take so much white people shit before he snaps. Welcome to my Robin Hood. King Keraun is robbing the hood with Robert De Niro as Bullseye. I'm sorry I gotta do this to you, Bambi, but I need lunch. Sir Elton John is Bambi and introducing Julie Spike Robinson as herself. Grab your cock feather and look down the shaft in the theater near you. No actual reindeers were harmed during the making of this. Actually, very few targets were harmed either. You know, I see why people love archery now, because this is something you don't even need a permit for if you got some home intruders. You know what I'm saying? You just take this from under the bed and pop, straight like that.
That's a good way to put it. Yeah, I like that.
Thank you. Robin, I'm so hood.
I'm a natural at archery. I think all black people should get into it. Imagine marching down the street strapped to the knives with bows and arrows. That'll scare the f*** out the KKK.